Audio filters manipulate the frequency spectrum, sometimes for functional mixing purposes, and sometimes for purely artistic reasons. We've previously looked at the EQ devices, which tend to use filtering for the former, and the comb filter, which concentrates on the latter. Now, let's take a look at the analog and digital filters, which can do a bit of both. Both types of filter share a few common features. The frequency band buttons select the section of the frequency spectrum that will be targeted, and the cutoff slider sets where the filtering takes place. Low pass allows the lower frequencies to pass through unaffected, while reducing the higher frequencies. And high pass does the reverse. You'd typically use these options to make broad changes, such as scooping an instrument's excessive bass to help other elements punch through, or removing unwanted harmonics produced by certain effects and techniques. Both filters have a bandpass feature, where the frequencies are reduced above and below the cutoff. And the digital filter also has band reject, which does the opposite. These can be good to generally alter the frequency spectrum at a certain point, or to create filter sweeps. If you really want to target specific frequencies though, then the EQ devices offer far more precision and versatility. Inertia determines how quickly parameter changes are applied. Lower values create sweeping effects, noticeably sliding from the old parameter setting towards the new one. Most people won't need to touch the oversampling option, but it can be changed to reduce any high frequency aliasing that may have been introduced by the filtering process. Increasing the oversampling does require more CPU power though, while turning it off reduces it, which can be handy if you're using something like an older laptop or a Raspberry Pi. The analog effect has a selection of three different models of hardware simulation, with two variations of the Moog style. Each one is constructed differently, giving them a particular character. And as you can see on the graph at the right, they also have a unique frequency response. Note that the diode model is only available as a low-pass filter. The resonance slider controls the strength of a ringing feedback loop affecting the frequencies around the cutoff value. Drive controls the strength of saturation that's applied to the audio as part of the filtering process. The digital effect also has a selection of three different models, with two variations of the Butterworth and Chebyshev styles. Compared to the analog filter, these digital models behave in a stricter, cleaner fashion. And this is helpful for accuracy when using the bandpass and reject options, because these make use of an additional slider, Q, which adjusts the width of the frequency band around the cutoff target. Only the bi-quad model uses resonance for low and high pass filtering, while the Chebyshevs feature a new ripple parameter that creates a more complex sound by introducing multiple peaks and troughs around the cutoff. A lot of the native effects are updated and improved forms of the ones used in previous versions of Renoise. Those older effects still exist, so that old songs and instruments behave as they should, but they're not normally available to the user. However, the native DSP context menu tool grants you the ability to insert them again, and this is most relevant to the filter effect, since it had four previous variants, if you include the scream filter. Although the analog and digital filters are technically superior, if you preferred that old school sound, then this tool lets you bring it forward. Link in the video description.